Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be going over yet another homework question that you might be going over around the beginning of your introductory macro or microeconomics courses. So we're going to be looking at what happens to the PPF given each scenario. And we're going to go over four different scenarios, and we're going to see what would happen to a standard PPF curve where there's two goods, so good Y on the Y-axis and good X on the X-axis. With that said, let's get into it. All right, guys, so our first scenario that we're going to be looking at is scenario A. Immigration into the nation impacts both sectors equally. So the first thing we need to do is determine, is this a positive or negative economic shock? And obviously immigration into the nation is a positive economic shock. That means we're going to be more productive in producing both good Y and good X. And it says that it impacts both sectors equally. So we're going to see a shift of the PPF curve, and it's going to be perfectly shifted out by the same amount for good X and good Y. So we'll say that this amount right here and this amount right here are the exact same. And then obviously we can connect these, and again, forgive my questionable drawing, but this would be a rightward shift of the PPF curve, where the production of good Y is strictly greater and the production of good X is strictly greater than before. Simple enough. Let's move on to the next example. So in example B, a new technology increases the productivity in the good X sector only. So this means that nothing actually changed in the sector for good Y. So nothing ever changed up at this intersection point, but the technology has increased the productivity for good X. So we're going to see that we're now able to, with the same amount of resources, produce more of good X and the exact same amount of good Y. So now our PPF curve is going to look something like this, where it never actually shifted out for good Y because the technology increase only affected good X right here. But good X were able to produce strictly more than before, so we actually see an increase for good X and we see no change for good Y. And our PPF will look something like this, where it rotates out and it pivots on the Y-intercept. Let's take a look at example C. So in example C, a negative shock impacts the amount of resources used in the production of good Y only. So the first thing we notice is that this is a negative economic shock and that it affects good Y only. So it's negative and it affects good Y only, which means that we're going to be able to produce strictly less of good Y. So the Y-intercept is going to be down here somewhere, but it doesn't impact good X at all. So X's production, maximum production, is going to be the exact same. And our PPF curve is now gonna look something like this, where we have a decrease here and it looks like it goes in a bit because now the maximum amount of good Y you can produce is strictly less than before. And so our PPF curve is going to pivot on the X-intercept and we'll be given a new Y-intercept down here. Finally, we have example D. New labor laws negatively impact both sectors, but the good X sector is affected more than the good Y sector. So again, we look and we have a negative impact and it affects both sectors. So we know that the intercepts are both going to move closer to the origin, but we don't know exactly how much. However, what we do know is that the good X sector is affected more than the good Y sector. So this means that the good X sector is actually going to shift in closer to the origin than the good Y sector. So we could have something that looks like this, a smaller decrease in Y and a greater decrease in X, so that our new PPF curve looks something like that, where both good Y and good X decreased. And so our PPF curve definitely shifted to the left, but it disproportionately shifted more on the x-axis than it did on the y, because this labor law affected the good x sector more. And there we have it, guys. Now we've looked at four different examples where the PPF curve has moved, and we've looked at what potential economic shocks caused it to do so. We appreciate all the support that you guys have shown on the channel. And if you enjoyed the video, let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics or homework questions you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.